Can you adjust the frequency and volume a bit?
Startups, originators, musica, cultura, the arts, politica, sports, news, technology, crime, tragedy, comedy, lahat ng makabuluhan.
We are your independent podcast content creator, straight from the Philippine Islands.
Mabuhay.
You're listening to Podcast.ph.
Welcome to the 24th episode of Martin's Man Cave on Podcast.ph. My name is Martin Andanar. You may listen to us through several ways. One is by logging on to our official website, Podcast.ph. You may also download us on iTunes. Just type Podcast.ph programs. Or you may go to SoundCloud.com and key in Podcast.ph. Please like, follow, or add us on Google+, Facebook, and Twitter. Just type Podcast.ph. Our guest today is one of the new generation Filipino politicians who have successfully proven that leadership through noble and trailblazing ideas and public management can be done. Sherwin was born on April 6, 1974 in Manila. His parents are William Gatchalian and Dihua Gatchalian. His siblings are Rex, Wesley, and Kenneth. He finished grade school and high school at the Grace Christian School in Quezon City in 1988 and 1991. He graduated at the Boston University at Boston, Massachusetts, with a Bachelor of Science major in Finance and Operations Management in 1995. He also took up courses at the Beijing Language and Culture University and at the Euromoney Institute of Finance from 1995 to 1997. Prior to politics, Sherwin was an executive of several businesses, namely Plastic City Corporation, Waterfront Philippines Incorporated, Forum Pacific Incorporated, Omico Mining Corporation, Air Philippines Corporation, the Wellex Group, Express Savings Bank, Genwire Manufacturing Corporation, and Bataan Polyethylene Holding Corporation. Sherwin first became congressman of Valenzuela in 2001 and moved to become city mayor of Valenzuela for three terms from 2004 to 2013. Currently, he is back at his old congressional district as its representative. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Congressman Sherwin D. Gatchalian. Thank you so much for accepting our invite to document your success here on podcast.ph.
Thank you, Martin. Thank you for inviting me. Pardon me for my voice. I had a bad cough and cold in the last few days. Mm-hmm. But thank you. Thank you for inviting me.
It's our pleasure, sir. Una sa lahat. A lot of people look at you. You're a congressman. You were a very successful mayor during your three terms. You're a bachelor, etc.
Bachelor. Kasali talaga bachelor.
Isa yun sa mga, isa yun sa mga unique selling proposition. But we want to know, Sherwin Gatchalian, in the flesh, as a person, not only as a congressman, as a mayor, but as a normal guy. Let's start from your parents. Please tell us about your parents.
Okay. My parents, my mom is from Apari, born and raised in Apari, Cagayan. And my dad, the man, is from Bulacan. And originally, we lived in Ubando, Bulacan. That's our original place. Like typical entrepreneurs, you know, they have our house and our factory is located in one compound. But unfortunately, our house and factory burned down. That's when we moved from Ubando to Valenzuela and set up our own factory there.
Mm-hmm.
I was really geared towards entering the business sector.
Mm-hmm.
Like any other entrepreneur family, I think a lot of the kids are groomed to work in the family business.
Uh-huh.
So I remember starting out when I was young, no? Bata pa ako, Martin, 13 mm-hmm. years old, I remember. Mm-hmm. Every summer for 2 months, my dad will mm-hmm. ask me to work inside the factory in the lowest positions.
Oh.
Una nga, I worked in the bodega, no, packing our products.
Mm-hmm.
I think second summer yata, I worked in the factory floor helping the supervisors there. for 4 years in high school, every summer, I never worked in the air-conditioned office. I worked malagang sa ground, no, sa factory. And then I made my rounds until college before leaving for the States. I think my last job, I remember, was working in sales. That was my last, siguro, air-conditioned job. But then again, sales ka eh. So, madalas ako nasa labas. And at that time, I remember, I wasn't provided with a driver, so I was driving. Pero that time, no, traffic wasn't so bad by. No, I think that was 1991. So, but my direction was really working in the family business. That's why I took up finance. Mm-hmm. And then I took up operations management mm-hmm. because we have a factory. Mm-hmm. And then when I was working in Valenzuela, in our factory, mm-hmm. I remember very clearly, you know, very vividly, I would tell my accountants, no, our accountants, oh, punta kayo sa City Hall to renew our business permit. But they would come back and always tell me na, sir, eh, ang daming hinihingi, eh, pati yung mga tao doon humihingi. Ganun. Sabi ko, bakit? Eh, kompleto naman yung dokumento natin. Mm-hmm. Sabi, sir, eh, alam niyo naman yung takbo, di ba? So, that opened my eyes, no, and my mind mm-hmm. to the state of governance here in our country. Kaya sabi ko, ba't gano'n, no? I mean, people are doing business, they want to pay taxes, they're employing people, but napapahirapan pa. Mm. So, I think the opportunity came when the previous congressman, no? So Congressman Serapio, Tony Serapio, who's my dad's close friend, mm-hmm. I think I bumped into him in one occasion, and sabi niya, oh, Sherwin, baka gusto mong tumakbo because I split our district, no? Valenzuela used to be one district. I split it into two. And your home barangay is the new district. So, walang congressman doon. So, maybe you wanna run. So, sabi ko, baka nga pwede because, you know, it's easy to complain from the outside. But, tingnan natin if you can do something from the inside. So, I ran for Congress 2001 and kahit papaano nanalo naman tayo without any experience in politics, without any experience in complaining. Sa awa ng Diyos nanalo tayo doon. And then that wasn't really my goal, Martin. I think if you really want change, local uh-huh. government mm-hmm. is the place to be. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And sabi ko to myself, I want to run for mayor the following election mm-hmm. because that's where real change happened. Mm-hmm. So I ran for mayor. I ran against the old family there. Awa rin ng Diyos, nanalo tayo. And from there, I started laying down the groundworks for improving mm-hmm. governance. And I remember, Martin, ito yung mm-hmm. pinaka-basic. Eh. And pet peeve ko ito actually uh-huh. prior to government. I don't know if you've been to other government offices, but don't you hate it when you go to a government offices and use the banyo? Parating ang banyo, ang baho, madumi. Sira, madumi.
Walang tissue paper,
walang tubig, yun, diba? Talang madumi.
Walang flush.
And that's what I saw, no, when I went into Valenzuela City Hall, no, 2004. Sabi ko, ba't ganito, no? The entire City Hall only has, I think, one banyo yata. Uh-huh. Tapos, ang dumi pa talaga. Uh-huh. Sabi ko, eh, kung yung banyo hindi maayos ng gobyerno, paano uh-huh. mo aayusin ng gobyerno? No? If you cannot fix a simple problem like the toilet, how can you fix government?
Parang metaphor lang yan ng the broken window.
Yes, yes. Diba? Exactly.
the broken toilet.
exactly.
But anyway, before we move to your public service accomplishments and right. what you have done in government, going back to your parents, no, your father and your mother, were they born in the Philippines or are they? Yeah. Yes,
yeah. They're born in the Philippines, uh-huh. but they weren't born in a wealthy family. No,
they're, so they're
very simple family.
Their grandparents, are their parents?
Their grandparents. My grandparents are from China.
Ah, yung daddy ng daddy mo.
Yes.
Tapos yung daddy ng nanay mo.
Yes.
So, first generation yung tatay niya.
Yes.
Oh, right. Yeah.
So,
right.
I think we're considered second generation.
As kayo, well. Ikaw. Yes, oh. yes. So, yes. Your grandparents moved here.
Yes.
And then they established residency and, of course, citizenship. Right. And they lived there. And,
right.
hindi sila ganun pa kasensado.
Hindi sila my dad's parents wala talaga, no? He was very poor. In fact, it came to a point na kwento ng dad ko na hindi nila alam kung anong kakainin nila next day. They were so poor, then they couldn't plan for the next day. Isang kain, isang tuka talaga.
What was the reason for your grandparents to migrate to the Philippines?
I think during that time, there was this great cultural revolution in China.
Mao Zedong.
Yeah, when everyone's being
brainwashed.
Exactly. I was going to say that. Actually, being brainwashed and told what to do. Uh-huh. And everyone was being punished also if they don't do what the ideology said. Marami, that was the time most of the biggest diaspora of Chinese outside of China.
Mm-hmm. So the person who started the Gatchalian businesses or the empire of the Gatchalian.
This man empire. Is your father? Just a few businesses lang.
Yeah.
Yeah, my father started it.
He's known as a plastic king.
At one point, no? At one point.
Why is that?
He was actually he became one of the biggest plastic manufacturers, no, in the entire country. Mm-hmm. At one point, I think that was during the 80s. Mm-hmm. So during the 80s, kasi there was this big industrial revolution in the Philippines, and he was one of those industrialists. Yun yung binigay sa kanyang parang nickname, no. Mm-hmm. Although ngayon we're not into plastics anymore.
Yeah. So plastic is no longer your. Well, you're no longer there. So what's the core business now?
Right now, we're into real estate, basically. So we have a few properties all over the nation.
And going back to your dad again, before we get into the business, etc. How did he start? How was he able to?
Actually, ito yung classic Martin, just borrowing the words from the Villar campaign, sipag at tiyaga talaga. Yun talaga yung classic. It took him almost 7 years to finish college. But education is very important to him. That's one thing that he imparted to us, no, to finish school. And sipag talaga, he started working in a plastic firm, working for somebody else. He learned the ropes. He started his own small factory. And then from there, he grew it. And then lumaka siya. At one point, I think we had almost 4,000 employees. Ganong kalaki in Valenzuela. And from there, he branched out to other businesses like real estate.
And your mom during those times, was she ever part of the company or was she housewife?
My mom was, she studied as a medical technician and then worked in a bank. And then that's how they met, I think. And then yung classic family business, my mom also acted as a finance manager, my dad as the owner. And then yung sister ng mom ko also worked in her factory as I think she was an accountant or something. Parang ganyan, classic, tulong-tulong ba?
Galing.
And then that was a good model. But then again, no, there are other factors that we can control, like electricity prices, labor unrest also became a factor. So we had to diversify into non-manufacturing businesses.
Essentially, the major principles and values, education, treasure education, and also sipag at tiyaga.
I think my dad at an early age imparted education as one of the most important goals in our lives. That's why I remember clearly bago kami umalis to the States, kasi my other brothers went to the US also. Sabi niya, pwede kayong kahit anong gusto niyong gawin, pwede niyong gawin. No, you can go out, you can have girlfriends, you can do whatever you want. No. No? Just make sure that you go home with your diploma. Yun lang. Kasi, ang sabi niya, I didn't manage to, it took me a while to finish my school. And when I finished it, I realized that it's very important in a person's life to have that value. No?
So being you're the eldest, right?
I'm the eldest.
So being the eldest, you set a good example.
I hope so. Natapos naman yung iba. Iba-ibang course lang kami, but natapos naman yung iba.
So now we're talking about your siblings, your brothers. Now, tell us more about your brothers. Who's your closest?
Actually, iba-iba, Martin. This is the funny part. No, actually, I got that question a few weeks ago. We're not close in a sense na kilala ko yung mga girlfriends nila or barkada nila. I socialize, mingle with their barkada. We're close in a sense of because of work. No, I'm close to my third brother who's now the mayor of Valenzuela, Sir X, because we talk about politics all the time. No. And then my last brother, who is a congressman, I'm close to him because we talk about politics and we used to talk about business before. My second brother, naman, we're close because he's in the business full time. So we talk about business. So everything related basically to what we do.
When you were kids, what did you used to play?
Grabe. I remember, Martin, when I was a kid, my biggest dream was to become a professional basketball player. Gusto maging pro eh.
And then?
Siyempre, medyo matangkad naman tayo.
Sa Grace Christian, naglaro ka?
Grace. And then, in fact, there was a time na ayaw ko nga pumunta ng States kasi alam ko pag pumunta doon, nothing's gonna happen kasi malaki. So, you have a better chance here, di ba? So, although, siyempre, my dad prevailed because better education is more important. So, but may isang problem ako, Martin, I realize. My back, ewan ko kung ano, parating nasasaktan yung back.
You have a Larry Bird back.
I guess so.
Si Larry Bird nakarating lang ng NBA.
Hindi, mas matagal pa. Nag-iwan ng favor. Ako, hindi na ako nag-take off eh. Yun, may parating masakit yung back ko eh. So, I realize sports not for me. At an early age, sabi ko hindi siguro atin to. So, I played pa rin until siguro that was 30, ganyan. Tapos suminto na ako.
Dapat kasi hindi ka nagbubuhat.
Hindi naman ako nagbubuhat eh. Depende.
Nang the barber.
Akala ko anong buhat isa sa mo.
Okay, so all of you are close in a different way. Yes. So it's all about professional.
It's more or less about work.
Hindi yung work. Personal. Like,
hindi kami gumigimik. Ganun.
How do you call each other? They call you kuya?
They call me.
Oh, kuya, wala pang asawa. Parang ganyan.
Wala. Ganun.
Walang ganyan. Pero mamaya tatanungin kita kung bakit wala pa. Alright. So you grew up a normal child? Have you played on the streets?
Yes. Actually, I was talking to this guy who was helping me with my communications plan. And we were talking about my background. Ganun rin, tanong niya. I when in Valenzuela, kasi our house is on top of our factory. And we live in a compound. So, karamihan kasi ng workers namin are from the province, no? So, we gave them a little dormitory in the compound. So, after school, ang kalaro ko yung mga anak ng mga factory namin.
So, yung mga patintero, mga ganyan. So,
alam mo, it really, really made a big difference in my life. Eh, because, you know, when at early age, you don't see the distinction between rich and poor. Hindi mo alam yung distinction between who's privileged and unprivileged. And everyone's just the same. Naglalaro kami sa basketball court. Ang common denominator namin at the time, basketball, actually. So, laro kami basketball, dadayo kami sa ibang barrio, sa ibang barangay.
Pero ikaw, manager?
Most of the time, ako yung manager.
No? The uniforme.
Most of the time, ako yung manager. After that, kakain lang kami sa isang tindahan.
Banana queue.
Tapos kwentuhan lang kami. Ice tubig. So, alam mo, malaking... In fact, if I have a kid, that should be the same model. Na at an early age, dapat hindi nila ma-feel yung distinction. Eh. There should be no distinction whatsoever. Because that will help them later on in their life. When they are exposed to the real world. No? Marami kasi mga bata ngayon, they think the Philippines is just Makati, Forbes, Das Marinas, Alabang. But the real world is really outside of that gates.
Do you still see these guys? The kids that used to play before?
Some of them actually are... some of them work for us. No? Some of them nag-OFW na. Some of them went to the province, but some of them work for us actually.
Wow. Yeah. So
it's in fact, we have some pag nandito sila nagre-reunion kami.
Galing. So yung
tagal na, these are really
kababata.
Oh,
bata mo talaga.
8-9 years old. Uh-huh. Ganun kami.
Hindi ganun naman yan eh. Although meron mas privilege pero pag nag-basketball pag uwi nyo, lahat kayo amoy araw.
Yeah.
Pare-parehas lang.
Saka basketball really ano, magandang
common denominator.
Common denominator for all walks of life.
Tell us about Grace Christian School. How did this school influence you?
Grace Christian School is very Christian.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a very conservative Christian school. Mm-hmm. No? Actually, the magandang question because it really influenced my life a lot. No? Mm-hmm. On top of that, no, Martin, mm-hmm. let mm-hmm. me just tell you, my mom is also a pastor.
Oh, wow.
So... Mm-hmm. Our school is a conservative Christian school, and mm-hmm. my mom is a pastor. So, the Christian mm-hmm. Upbringing really dominated my life.
Mm-hmm.
And Grace Christian naman, mandatory doon ang Sunday school.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have to study the Bible and go to church every now and then. Every once a week, I think pala. Mm-hmm. Every once a week.
Mm-hmm.
And then, bawal doon holding hands.
Oh, ganun ba?
Bawal nagliligawan sa school. Uh-huh. In skirt naman ba eh, dapat merong below the knee. Parang ganyan. Ay, very conservative talaga.
Kala ko nakatali yung sapatos.
Conservative. I remember maraming na-expel because nahuli, nag-holding hand. Very conservative talaga.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So,
hanggang ngayon, ganun pa rin.
Parang ganun pa rin eh. I think ganun that's rin, really the built-in culture of that school eh.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so lumaki na kami. In the school setting pa lang, we're exposed to the Bible mm-hmm. and Christianity and living a Christian life. And then when I go home, my mom is a pastor, so that also influenced my upbringing mm-hmm. a lot. So mm-hmm. I think that really helped me, especially now that I work in government, mm-hmm. when temptation is very heavy,
mm-hmm.
When power is very can be very power is also very tempting,
mm-hmm.
and abuse of power can be very tempting also.
Well, during our time in high school, because we're of the same age, you know, I remember that during those times, grabe yung kidnapping. Eh. And
yes.
I think Grace Christian is a Chinese Catholic school, Christian school.
Yes.
How did you deal with that?
Honestly, Martin, I'll be honest. One of my family members got kidnapped. No?
Oh wow! Well, your brother?
My tita.
Your tita. Okay.
And. Yun talaga really. Although nasa States ako no, nag-aaral ako. Mm-hmm. But I remember my mom calling me and medyo depressed because na-kidnap kayo yung tito ko. Mm-hmm. Kaya naging ano rin kami. That's why we had to leave Valenzuela and mm-hmm. built another house outside of Valenzuela. Because mm-hmm. Valenzuela became the hotbed of... andun kasing headquarters ng KMU, Martin.
Mm-hmm.
So it became a hotbed for... this type of activities.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to relocate outside.
Mm-hmm.
It created a lot of damage in the entrepreneur industry. Maraming mga negosyante talagang umalis.
As a Filipino Chinese, no. A Filipino Chinese politician at that, no. When you look back and when you hear stories of Filipino Chinese businessmen or families who get kidnapped, how do you feel about it as a Filipino Chinese?
Alam mo, I issued a statement one time and uh-huh. I told them that let's face reality.
Uh-huh.
And the reality is the government cannot protect each and every Filipino Chinese or any businessman mm-hmm. for that matter
mm-hmm.
when they are under threat of kidnapping.
Mm-hmm.
We just have to do the most practical things. No? Mm-hmm. For example, kung kaya niyo naman kumuha ng bodyguard, kumuha kayo ng bodyguard.
Mm-hmm.
If you can equip your house with CCTV, then equip your house with CCTV. Mm-hmm. If you can put security guards at your gate, then you mm-hmm. put security guards.
Mm-hmm.
And simple techniques like, of course, don't broadcast to everyone where are you going, mm-hmm. what's your schedule every day. So these are the some measures that mm-hmm. can help you avoid kidnapping.
Mm-hmm.
We have to be conscious. We have to face reality. Mm-hmm. I think that's the best. That's the best case. That's the best thing we can do.
All right. Going back to, so you finished high school at Grace Christian School, and then you moved to a Boston University. What are your memorable moments at Boston?
Actually, Martin, at that time, di ba marami? Actually, on the contrary, actually, this is a funny part. On the contrary, because before I left, and since I am the eldest, and my dad really imparted me that education is very important. Mm-hmm. I really tried my best. No? Mm-hmm. Or not tried my best. I really did everything to finish school. Mm-hmm. Although nag-enjoy rin tayo, but I really devoted a lot of my life.
It's a beautiful campus.
Very beautiful.
I've seen it, and it goes all the way. And there's an old street, or there's one of the main roads. Mm-hmm. You take a train. It's in the middle.
Commonwealth Avenue.
Yeah, then it takes you all the way to Boston College. Right?
Yes, sa dulo yung Boston College.
That's where Ninoy lived, diba?
Right. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Actually, you start off with, it's in a tunnel eh. Uh-huh. They call it the T, ewan ko, ganun pa rin eh. T ang tawag doon sa subway. Mm-hmm. So when you get out of the T, the first stop is Boston University.
Yes. Uh-huh.
So pag sumakay ka doon, the very last end is Boston College na. Mm-hmm. And actually, my fondest memory is really, I met a lot of good friends also there. Marami rin mga Pinoy. And
dito rin. Tapos nag-aral doon.
And then, siguro pinakamasaya akong times is freshman year ko eh. Mm-hmm. I remember. Because you're still exploring, meeting a lot of people. Uh-huh. And we would travel from different states, meeting other friends. So, masaya rin.
Okay, I am curious, again, coming from a Filipino-Chinese enterprising and very wealthy family, what made you decide to, or what made it, how did you convince your parents to say yes for you to join politics? You know, because while others would just be happy to continue the business, rest on their laurels, enjoy the money, work hard, less stress. But before you answer that, let's pause for a short break and play one of your favorite songs by The Temper Trap. The song is entitled Sweet Disposition. What makes this song one of your favorite songs?
You know, I remember, I think I was coming from abroad, and then I don't watch movies here. Uh-huh. So the only time I watch movies is the airplane. That's the only time, Martin. I'll be honest.
Siguro yung ganun yung pangatlong tao nakausap ko na. Doon na nakapanood.
Siguro politician yun. But that came out eh. Yung, what's the title of that movie? 40 Days of Summer.
Oh.
And that was the, parang the main song or the theme song. So, but that movie is also nice. Mm-hmm. It's a very nice movie. I very rarely watch love movies also, but that was a few times na by chance na switch ko siya. So from there, I really like the music.
All right. Let's play Sweet Disposition here in Martin's Man Cave on podcast.ph. You are still listening to Congressman Sherwin Gatchalian. Don't go away. All right. The music of Temper Trap and Sweet Disposition. We're back with Congressman Sherwin Gatchalian. The hanging question is, why politics if you can just run your business empire and make more money with less stress?
Actually, tama ka, Martin. I remember one time we were having dinner. Every Sunday kasi may dinner ka may family. And I opened this idea up. Talagang violent reactions from especially my mother, no? She's a pastor, so very conservative. Just imagine she's trying to avoid violence, trying to avoid controversies, and then one of her sons wanted to go into this type of industry. So nagkaroon na ng malaking debate. But I told them, I told my family that my goal really is to change local government. And at least local government in Valenzuela. So I wanted to share my experiences, use my skill to change governance in Valenzuela. So na-appreciate naman nila yon.
So napapayag din sila. Eventually, well, of course.
Actually, hanggang ngayon, given a choice, my mom will say, oh, baka, you know, it's already enough. Nag-mayor ka na, ilang tagal na. Baka you wanna take it easy ready. But sabi ko, mom, parang you contributed already and parang there's so many things to contribute pa. So let's do this until the people, eventually the people uh-huh. naman will dictate whether they like you or they don't like you. Uh-huh. It's not uh-huh. for you naman to say.
Oh, so nung naging opposed yung mami mo sa pagtakbo mo, ngayon tatlo na yun.
Ngayon tatlo na. Actually, that's true. Kaya nga pag nakikita kami, Martin, uh-huh. until now, every election time, umiiling na lang siya ng ulo para
gastos.
Aside from gastos, kasi talagang naman ano eh, di ba Martin, if you read the papers, daming uh-huh. mga elected-related violence, mm-hmm. maraming political-related violence, so yeah. Talaga, if you're a mother, medyo ano ka talaga.
Mm, ilag ka doon. So, what is your most unforgettable experience in politics so far?
I think the most unforgettable was my first term. My first time to join into politics. And that's where you get exposed to yung tinatawag nilang dirtiness, no? Yung dumi ng politics. And I remember clearly, I was 27 years old. I was campaigning. So, personality ko kasi is positive, put down your platforms, tell the people what you can do, explain to the people your background.
Mm-hmm.
But yung kalabang ko was really attacking me.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of the attacks were personal. Like, for example, I'm Chinese raw ako. Uh-huh. Hindi raw ako dapat tumakbo dahil I'm Chinese. Ganyan. So, and then, walang experience, of course. 27 lang. And mm-hmm. then, nandyan na rin yung mga, yan, kasi, ano yan, anak mayaman yan. Wala namang pakialam yan sa mga mahirap. So, mga ganun ba?
Mm-hmm.
So, that's where you feel the real politics ready.
No? Uh-huh.
And, nakalungkot because I until now, nalulungkot ako pag may naririnig akong ganyan in our uh-huh. country. But, I think that's part of the game. Eh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mahirap ba na walang first lady?
Sa akin, Martin, parang...
You don't know the difference.
Anyway. Oh, eh. I think the flexibility really worked for me. Yeah?
Uh-huh.
Because, when I talk to their constituents, sometimes mm-hmm. kasi I have meetings on Sundays. Eh.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And, talaga, itong Sunday meron.
Talaga.
And then my constituents will say, syempre, I'll apologize. Parang, sorry ho kung Sunday. Sabi niya, okay lang ho, Kong, dahil alam namin busy kayo, this is the only mm-hmm. time. And alam rin naman namin na wala kayong pamilya, kayo, wala kayong uwian eh.
Boom!
Aray! Yeah, pero okay naman siya. Pero natatawa sila.
Parang papaninig. What is your political ideology? Are you liberal, conservative, pro-establishment, pro-labor? I mean, coming from Boston University, you must be liberal-minded.
I think I'm in between liberal and a little bit in the center.
Uh-huh.
I still believe that government should have a lot of control in certain industries and leverage mm-hmm. on it. No? Especially when a country like ours is not so progressive yet, no? Mm-hmm. And we're still developing. Kumbaga, extreme free market can be detrimental to our people.
Mm-hmm.
I'll give you a case in point, Martin. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, utilities. No,
mm-hmm.
If it's too... I think when we're too liberal in our utilities...
Mm-hmm.
Eventually, the poor people will pay for that. No? Mm-hmm. And in the long run, it's very hard for our constituents themselves to have developed. So, it has to be balanced, I think. Mm-hmm. But in a sense, I'm not so extreme left also na dapat puro government na lang.
Mm-hmm.
I want to put also a lot of... efficient... I think the private sector can be part of governments and mm-hmm. it can make it efficient.
Mm-hmm. So, kailangan may market forces then.
Definitely, definitely.
When it comes to your political decisions in Congress or in your local government unit, no? Ano yung usual guiding principles mo when it comes to governance?
Actually, I have itemized three things. Very important, very basic, Martin. Actually, alam mo, sa governance, hindi man rocket science. Eh. First, you lay out principles, then you follow them. My first is, you really have to start from the top. It really has to start from the top. Management by example or leadership by example is very important. For example, pag sinabi mong no corruption, it has to start from you. Pag nade-detect ng tao na, si mayor, merong palusot, then
uh-huh.
it's very hard to preach no corruption when you yourself is accused of corruption, especially if there's very strong evidence. Mm-hmm. Pangalawa, the small thing matters. No? Mm-hmm. Like yung banyo na, na sinabi ko, so those are little things, but it really matters to everyone. And it's a symbol. Eh? If you cannot fix the small things, then you cannot fix the entire government system. The third thing that I learned from in governance is you really have to listen to the people. And when I say listen, you really have to use all mediums to listen, like social media, internet. Mm-hmm. Yung age na magagawa, pupunta ka sa yung pupunta ka doon sa tao and then magpapa-meeting ka, hindi na yun yung listening eh. Uh-huh. You have to open yourself up to new technology to listen to everything. Mm-hmm. And when you start listening, you have to action. Dapat kasunod doon, action na.
Mm-hmm. You're very active in social media, and you're also active in visiting your constituents, not only your constituents, but also basically the entire nation. How do you balance it? Of course, you don't have a family, that's why you can at least do some social media. How do you do that?
Balance talaga, management. You just have to manage your time.
So you give what, 1 hour for social media, 1 hour for this, parang ganun? Or,
actually, malaking bagay ngayon yung mga mobile capabilities ng cellphone, iPad. Mm. And I have a team. But I really guide them, no, for what to post and what to do. Uh-huh. But definitely, ako kasi interest ko rin, like you, Martin, is social media, internet. So I use the internet a lot. Mm. And then I look for new technologies. Mm-hmm. I subscribe to, let's say, mga Mashable, mga ganyan, to look for new technologies that we can use. Mm-hmm. And then even when I was a mayor, sometimes I don't papatawag lang ako, hindi ba, magpapa-appointment ng mga technology provider. I will just tell them, oh, present to me what's new there, out there, what can we do. So just to update your knowledge about technology.
Speaking of technology, yung meron nga kayong drone, di ba? Dun sa Valenzuela. may drone kayo pag nakikita pag may punsan yung baha. Ang galing.
Tsaka ano, in CCTV, na kami fiber optic. Yeah. So,
and then you have the parang multi-purpose ambulance or...
Yung mga equipment.
Equipment,
yes.
Galing. Yeah. So all of these, ito yung produkto ng ano, technology.
You just have to keep on innovating, Martin. Not only in governance, but also in life. No, you just have to keep on innovating. You have to keep on learning. You have to. I'm 40 na tayo, ako, I've made so many mistakes. I made some good decisions, but eventually you just have to keep on evolving, keep on innovating.
Once we have to kiss a lot, except sa babae, no?
Oo nga. Kailangan na hindi natin na-evolve pa.
Hindi ma-innovate.
Yan, hindi ma-innovate eh. Ako, kung style ko, dapat ma-innovate na siguro.
Okay. Maybe we can go out and drink one of these days. Give you a thing or two, lesson. Okay. Let's talk about the family business. Your brother handles the business now.
My second brother, si Kenneth.
Si Kenneth, yeah. All right. Usual question to ng mga Pilipino.
Yeah.
Who gets most out of the business share? Paano ang hati-hatian sa mana? If you're a politician and basically you're not there running the business, so sino yung, I'm assuming mas malaki yung ang share ng brother mo.
Actually, hindi. Actually, I'm lucky because my brothers are very understanding. And then si Kenneth is a very, actually, he's a very simple guy. Tsaka hindi siya yung, actually, lucky ako because my brothers, hindi sila mabilang na, I'm going to work 18 hours a day, therefore I get this much. You know? Ikaw, wala ka naman, so you don't get... Hindi naman kami ganun. We're actually a team player family. No? So, my Kenneth has a responsibility in the family business. They know that I'm with government, so it's hard for me to join. But during the family dinner, doon kami nag-uusap-usap about business and politics. So we make major decisions in that family business, in that dinner about family business. So, but Martin, hindi naman kami malaki. No? We're just a small family business. So, I think in family, it's important that everyone knows their role.
All right. On a lighter note, we're talking about dinner over dinner. What's your favorite ulam, pagkain, over dinner. What's the family specialty?
Actually, my mom likes to cook. Pero walang ano eh. Sometimes nagluto siya na Chinese, of course. Sometimes Pinoy food. Wala talagang usual. But na-notice ko lang lately, mahilig ang mom ko sa steak.
Wow.
Steak.
So lately, yeah.
Lately. I think because of my dad. My dad like steak ko also. So medyo napapa-western yung pagkain natin lately.
From Chinese to Western. How do you have your steak? Medium, rare?
Medium rare ako,
Martin. Wow, really?
Oh, medium rare. Ikaw?
Ano, pag sinasabi nila, pag 40 na, daan-daan na
sa medium rare. Medium rare. So sashimi, bawal na
kasi ano, yung mga cancer of the... Of the bituka.
Kaya nga, parang colon cancer. Pero Marty, parang hindi ko maisip, 40 na nga ako eh.
Oh.
I mean, I turned 40 last April until now. Oh. Parang it's such a... Parang hindi mo pa masink in, no? 40 ka na, and then next year, 41.
Oh.
maybe 41 in 5 months.
Imagine, if you get married and you have a son at the age of 40, pag nag-20 anak mo, 60 ka na.
Oo. Di ko na siguro siya makakita mag-asawa.
pag may pag hindi mo na makita yung apo mo.
Hindi na. Wala na. Hindi na iniisip yun.
Di ba na? Di ba na? Patay ka na naman.
actually, yun yung sinasabi ko.
Alright. Okay. So, why are you single? Before you answer that, let's play another song from your playlist. This is When you say nothing at all.
Actually, favorite ko yan dahil right. Pag iniimbita ako sa karaoke, yan ang pinakamadaling kantahin.
Ayun.
Eh.
Itong When You Say, memorize mo ito.
Mabilis kantahin ito pag sa karaoke.
Oh, here it is. When You Say Nothing at All, a song by Ronan Keating. No? And we will be back with Congressman Sherwin Gatchalian. Stay with us. The music of Ronan Keating and When You Say Nothing at All. You're still listening to Martin's Man Cave on Podcast.ph. Kasama pa rin po natin si Congressman Sherwin Gatchalian. And our hanging question earlier, no? The multi-million peso question. Why are you still single?
Oo nga, Martin. Hindi ko... Maybe that's one thing I haven't innovated yet, no? But para... Ay, that's destiny. Parang si Presidente, I think destiny talaga eh.
So is it a matter of you haven't met the right person?
Probably. Well, I think so.
What
I don't know if it's my own mentality. I think when you're in that stage of settling down, you're open to settling down. Maybe I'm not yet in that stage yet. That's why it's also not coming, that person's not coming, I think. So, but then again, no, I have to be realistic. I'm 40 and kagaya na sinabi mo, I won't see my grandchildren. Pero then again, patay na nga ako noon. So,
who cares? So, parang ganun.
Yeah. So I think dadating rin yan. Baka later on.
What's the longest relationship period?
Actually, Martin, for a 40-year-old, only have 2 relationships.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Kanti lang.
The first one was what? 20
the first
years
one was 2000. Mm-hmm. And the last, and then that lasted for 2 years. And then this one.
That's long, huh?
Yep. And then interval, matagal. So I think almost 6 years. And then.
Mukhang broken-hearted ka.
Hindi naman. Actually, masaya nga ako noon. Masaya nga ako noon.
Mukhang na-picture ko, nasa shower ka, nakaupo. Tapos yung shower ka, magkaroon.
Actually, nung nangyari nga yun, parang sumaya nga ako. Sobrang saya eh.
sana hindi siya ikinig.
Actually, yun nga yung nagtampo nga siya after because sabi niya, parang sobrang saya kaya ito nag-break tayo.
Pero siya nakipag-break?
Hindi, ako.
Yun. Ikaw. Yun, okay. Okay. It's because of work or?
No, it's just ano lang, parang you wanted
space,
freedom. Yeah. Usual, no? Naman, maririnig mo naman. Eh, diba?
It's not you, it's me.
Yan naman yun. And then the last one was 2007. That lasted for a year.
And now you're single?
Single. Or? So, been single since that year.
So, you're not dating
anyone? Matagal. Wala,
okay.
Wala.
Okay. Oh, well. Mamaya, pagkatapos ito, usap tayo.
Over scotch.
And your friends are, most of your friends, I suppose, they're married already?
Siguro mga 90%. 90%.
So meron pa yung...
Kaya nakakatawa nga because you see the transition. Eh. Uh-huh. First, you get invited to the weddings, then children parties, and now, debut na. Can't believe I get invited to a debut.
Nung wedding.
Hopefully, hindi pa wedding. Hindi binyag ulit nung anak niya.
Tapos ninong ka.
Gabi.
Tapos binyag pa.
Actually, ano, you see, when you're single, parang you see this significant activities happening in front of your eyes. Kasi when you're married, parang you're tending to your own affairs, your own family affairs. Pero ito talagang you can see everyone moving from different transitions.
Do you keep a circle of friends? Like your core?
Yeah, I have a group of friends na since high school. We've been friends since we were 12 years old, 13 years old. Then I had friends... when I started working in our family business. Mm-hmm. This is before politics. Mm-hmm. And then when I moved to politics, I had friends from there. Mm-hmm. Ito yung mga freshman nung 2001 Congress, mm-hmm. nung 12th Congress. Mm-hmm. Ito yung sila Gilbert Rimulya, mm-hmm. those guys sila Bahamitra. Mm-hmm. We still keep in touch until now. Mm-hmm. And then I have friends from this... Itong mga political, itong last political phase in my career. Ito latest pala.
How do you decipher, how do you distinguish between a person who's sincere, like now, that you're who you are, a person who's sincere and a person who's just there for the opportunity?
Martin, I think only time can tell. Uh-huh. It's very difficult to, of course you'll have first impressions, but it's very difficult to whether that first impression is really that person. So I think you just have to let time tell. You know?
So when do you say this person is already full of bullshit? when do you say that?
Depende rin on the gravity of that bullshit. Kung araw-araw kang binubullshit, syempre, 2 or 3 days, ayaw mo na, di ba? Kung medyo creeping bullshit, medyo tumatagal. But malaman mo naman, tandaan na tayo, Martin, 40 years old, both of us are 40 years old. Pero malaman mo naman. But syempre, like you give everyone a chance, baka good intentions naman to, sincere. But eventually, you'll know naman who's bullshitting you.
It's a good intention bullshit.
Right. But you know what, funny, I've met a lot of people.
A lot of bullshit.
Kasama rin bullshit. But I met a lot of sincere people. Just by going out, attending mga parties, attending social events. You meet a lot of good people and a lot of good friends.
Mm. I meet a lot of girls too, you know, in those parties. okay. Lighter note, and then in a few minutes we'll wrap up. What are your hobbies?
Hobbies right now, Martin, I just run. I try to run about 8 to 10K per session.
Wow.
About 3 to 4 times a week. Mm-hmm. So, yun na lang ang pinaka-exercise ko ngayon. Although, honestly, whenever I travel with the Vice President sa grupo niya, si Vice masipag mag-exercise. Uh-huh. He walks 2 hours a day from 6 a.m. to 8.
Grabe, no?
Grabe, grabe talaga. And, talaga niyan, routine niya talaga yan. So running, I walk also.
How many hours do you sleep?
On the average, 5 to 6.
Wow.
Kaya medyo nagkasakit ako lately.
Mm. Kasi tumatakbo ka, tapos busy ka. Then...
Oh, I realize you also need to recharge siguro once a week or twice a week siguro. Mm. I mean, sleep longer.
Of course, yeah. To give your body enough time
wala
to...
Wala namang katabi, kaya... kaya maaga nagigising.
mas maaga kang magigising kung may katabi ka.
Baka hindi ka na makatulog.
okay. You mentioned already your pet peeve, no? The number one pet peeve is a toilet. What are the other pet peeves?
Sa akin yan, that pet peeve naman is more on the governance side. But another one, but ito, it's very hard to control, is... people who are always late.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. But sometimes, but itong pet peeve na ito, you have to have some leeway rin because of the traffic situation. But yung mga taong parating late yan, medyo hindi ako masyadong dyan.
So hindi excuse yung It's a Filipino culture.
Lalo na yon. I think that one is really yan, bullshit na talaga yan.
Bullshit talaga yan.
But yung mata-traffic siya, baka, and then, for example, umbulan, yun, medyo talaga. Ano. But but if it's on a normal condition, I think they should be on time.
When do you get impressed by a person or someone you meet or...
Girls or...
Anyone.
Anyone?
Anyone.
This is in general.
In general, yeah.
I remember clearly when I was working in our family business, one of my favorite things to do is to talk to our suppliers. Kasi these suppliers of ours are mostly entrepreneurs. And they might be small, they might be medium, they might be micro. But in business skills, mga entrepreneurs, iba eh. Parang some of them come from literally zero. No, they will take risk, put their hard work, earn money, start to start their own business, be successful in business. You learn a lot from these little stories, and you build on those little stories. I'm, of course, I get impressed also with the big people, no, but I'm also impressed with the smaller success stories.
Who are the people that you'd like to thank?
Syempre my parents. No? My parents are really laki talaga yung sacrifice nila and understanding. And I'm not a perfect child, no, but I think my parents have been really, really patient, no? With me. And along the way, I've met a lot of people who have been with us, no, up and down. People who work in our family business, like in corporate counsel namin, si Attorney Mercado, who's been with us, you know, good times, bad times, he's stayed with us. Mga partners namin sa business, sila Mr. Magadia, ganun rin, good times, bad times, they're with us. You learn to appreciate people who stayed with you during your lowest moment. And alam mo naman, Marty, sa negosyo, it's a cycle. And there was also a time that we're really, you know, we got hurt with the financial crisis. And you remember those people who stayed with you.
What is the end goal? Do you see yourself running for higher office?
I'll take it step by step, Martin. Hopefully, this coming election, I can run for a higher office. If we make it, then we reassess and see if we can run for another higher office. But we'll take it step by step. But definitely, I want to seek a higher position.
Before I ask you the final serious question, ano mo na ang paborito mong kulay? Favorite color?
Ako, I've always liked blue.
Blue.
Pero ang campaign color ko, red.
Oh, why is it red?
Na-inherit ko na yan kay Congressman Serapio eh. The one who introduced me to public service. Kasi I joined his team eh. So I adopted his color. And then when he passed away, parang I just carried over that color. But that color has been quite lucky for me.
Your favorite Filipino meal?
Alam mo, na-learn ko lately, binalot.
Binalot, ha? Anong laman ng binalot?
Hindi, syempre yung classic na yung...
itlog na pula.
Itlog na pula tsaka adobo.
Wow, sarap na.
Sarap, ha? Sarap siya.
Pero di mo pwedeng baluto yan na mainit yung kanin. Masisira yung binalot.
You have to eat it right away. Hindi mo pwedeng matagal yun. Pero masarap, masarap.
Otherwise, binalot na panis.
Pero syempre, yung mga... may mga, actually, dami na natin Pinoy food na masasarap pa. Yung mga restaurants. Like, for example, yung, of course, Abe.
Abe.
It's one of my favorites talaga. Ayan, that one, I can eat every week. I can go there
talaga?
Every week. Yeah.
So, anong favorite mo doon sa Abe?
Sa Abe, paborito ko doon yung rice na sa...
Nako, nasa Kawayan.
Kawayan, sarap yan.
Ginatok-tok-tok, ginaganong-ganan.
Actually, hindi ako masyado kumakain rice, but that's the only time kumakain.
Di ba, pag pumunta ako sa bahay mo, kadalawang kawayan, tok-tok-tok naman ang mga magising ka.
Sarap yun, sarap. Sarap yun. Saka yung gising-gising, actually, sarap yun.
Sarap doon. Gising-gising.
Abe is actually one of my favorites.
Sarap doon. Anong paborito mong...
But, you know, I've been going around Martin the Nation. Ang daming mga local food na hindi pa natin natatry pero sasarap pa. For example, I just tried itong sa Camsor, no? Yung mga Camsor version na lang ng mga Bicol food. Sarap doon.
Yung mga ano, di ba? Yung mga Bicol Express.
Bicol Express, yung mga... basta, marami silang luto na may gata eh. Sarap.
At anong tipo mo sa babae? Maputi? Kayumanggi?
Wala na. Alam mo, Martin. Nung, alam mo, siyempre, nung bata tayo, marami tayong tipo. Physically.
Bland.
Bland. ngayon, wala na. Someone that you get along with. That's someone you get along with. Na bland.
Mayroong aso bland. Babae.
I think some you get along with lang. Mahirap na ngayon eh. Hirap na pumili. Tanda na natin eh.
Eh, mayroong marami dyan. Would you go for what? Kaedad mo or what, 5 years younger?
Siguro a little bit younger siguro. Oh, pati naman sobrang, 18, ganyan. Naman sobrang bata. Siguro mga 5 years younger. Ganyan.
Mahirap na mga anak yun.
5 to 10 years. Actually, 10 years, pwede na nga ngayon.
Oh, 30, sir, pwede yan. Kasi pag mag 35 ka to 40, hindi na mahanap. Hindi ka na magkaanap.
10 years pala. 10 years.
Ibig sabihin, pag antayin ka ng 50, parang papakasalan mo.
Yun, 20 years younger. 30.
Para sabihin, idol. Alright. What is your dream for the Filipino?
Actually, time and memorial naman, the end goal was to improve the lives of our people, mm-hmm. to bring them out of poverty. Mm-hmm. I think, having said that, my ultimate dream really is to have a constituency, or our country will be considered one of the countries that focuses a lot on education, mm-hmm. and our constituents are highly literate. Mm-hmm. Very intelligent, very innovative. Mm-hmm. We have Filipinos who are scientists, engineers, inventors. I really believe that to create value, you have to have highly intelligent constituents. And you can only achieve that if our education system is strong. So that's my dream for the country.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your life story and your dream with us here in Podcast.ph and Martin's Man Cave. Sana pag naging senador ka na, may part 2 pa.
Of course. Thank you, sir.
All right. Thank you so much. Kasama natin po si Congressman Sherwin Gatchalian. And his last song that we will play here in this program is The Bright Side by The Killers. So, can you explain to us, sir, why?
Actually, ito medyo malayo nga to, uh-huh. dahil I remember, ito may historical significance to. Uh-huh. I remember yung, di ba, I was telling you about my first girlfriend when we broke up. Mm-hmm. This is one of the most popular songs sa labas ng labas eh. Mm-hmm. So, every time siyempre kaka-break mo lang. So, gumigimik ka, you go out with your friends. Parating lumalabas to. Mm-hmm. So, it became my favorite song at that time.
Yun.
It's symbol of freedom eh.
hanggang sa dulo may patama pa rin. mukhang masakit ang loob mo, sir. Mukhang meron kang
hindi naman. It was just a transition that time.
And I suppose she's married now? Or
no, she's not married now. Actually, I just bumped into her to a common friend last night.
Alright, thank you so much, Congressman.
Thank you, Martin. Thank you.
Here it is, The Killers and Mr. Brightside. Here inside Martin's Man Cave on podcast.ph. Thank you so much.
This podcast.ph presentation is supported by Martin Andanar's Homecast Studio and audio.ph.
Sherwin has received numerous awards, namely the Manila 40 Under 40 International Development Leaders 2013, the Outstanding Young Men, or TOYM, in 2011, Honoree for Public Service, Silver Humanitarian Service Cross Award 2014, the Silver USA Award in 2013, the Champions of Health Governance Awardee in 2013, Best Among Best Practices Local Chief Category in 2013, Seal of Good Housekeeping Bronze Category 2012, and Galing Pok Awards 2012, Top 10 Outstanding Local Governance Programs 3S in Public Service Program, and many, many more awards.